Using the SFC program, I'm going to walk through a proposed solution for Chapter 4, Exercise 2A. This exercise asks you to design the flowchart or the pseudocode for a program that accepts a candy name, the price per pound, and the number of pounds sold in the average month. Then display the item's data only if it is a best-selling item. Best-selling items are those that sell more than 2,000 pounds per month. This example is going to actually involve multiple flowcharts because I'm going to suggest using modular programming. So the first flowchart that I create will be the main program logic, which is going to define our variables and then call different modules. In order for this exercise to be complete, by the way that I'm doing it with the modules, I will have to write a flowchart, draw a flowchart, or write the pseudocode for each of the modules that I reference in my main program. You know, we're going to start by creating a new project and give it a title, author, and course ID. I'm going to call it Exercise 2A Main because it is the main program. And let me remind you how to use this program. The left side is going to show the flowchart. The right side is going to show the pseudocode. By default, it is not showing pseudocode. It's actually showing C++. So using the view menu, we're going to switch to generic style pseudocode. Okay. Back on the left side with our flowchart. Our start and stop, our start and stop terminals are there. We're going to select the little dot in between. And we're going to use the edit menu to insert a process, a sequential process. I'm going to choose a sequential process because all I'm going to do right now is declare my variables. Now, you can write the word declarations, I will. But if you do not, I will not count that against you. And the other kind of a negative part of using this program is I don't have the opportunity to put each declaration on a separate line. Okay? That's one of the downfalls of this program. So I'm going to declare three variables and one constant. The first variable is a string variable for the name of the candy. And then a couple of numeric variables, one for price per pound, another numeric variable for pounds sold. And then finally, a numeric constant, and I put the constant names in all uppercase to differentiate them from variables, the minimum number of pounds, so pounds min, and for that we want to assign a value of 2,000, so we know that 2,000 pounds is what's going to be determined whether or not it's a best-selling item. So we click OK. The flowchart side of the screen adds that process with the appropriate text, although the text isn't aligned as well as I'd like it to be. And then on the right side in the pseudocode, we see our declarations here. Right. The next thing we want to do is ask the user for input. But remember, we're going to use modules. So quite often, one of the first things that you do in a program when you're using modularization is do that what they call a housekeeping module, where you might set up some initializations. In this case, we're going to get the first or the priming read of the name of the candy, the price per pound, and so on. So I'm simply going to insert, using the edit menu, insert. This time, I want to insert a call. For a procedure or function. We're going to call a procedure or a module. And that module is going to be called housekeeping. Remember to put the parentheses on the end of your module names. And by the way, we did not have any arguments to pass on, so we left that second line blank. We'll do this again. The next module that we're going to call is our detail module. Again, we're going to call it detail, and you could call it main loop if you wanted to. It's where you're going to, if not in this program, we're not going to have a loop, but if you were to process multiple items, then you would probably have that in a loop. Okay. And no parameters to be passed to this module, so we can leave that blank. And then finally, the finish module or finish up module. Insert one more call. Again, I keep using the term module. They refer to it as a procedure or a function. Okay. Now, that's our main flowchart, our main program's flowchart. We're going to need to create a flowchart for the housekeeping module, one for the detail module, and one for the finish module. Now, what I'm going to do is, if you're using the SFC program, you've got to somehow get a print screen capture of this and paste it into your template, unless, of course, you just give me this particular file to open up in SFC. But ideally, you'd use some sort of screen capture tool to just grab, in this case, just that little bit. Now, your computer may not have that, so I'm going to grab just this little piece here. I'm going to make a copy of that and paste it into our template, which actually I've already done that here. Pasted that into the template. Okay. And then now what I'm going to do for the sake of time is I'm going to end this video and then start a new video discussing the other three flowcharts, and I'll go through those a little bit quicker so that maybe I can get all three of them into one video. Thank you.